welcome to Cafe Enoma's Mega Music Reaction Fest 2, and we are going to give our reaction to Nine Inch Nails singing Perfect Drug, and this is a Patreon request by our patron Nick.
Yeah, let's get started with our first time single take honest reaction. It's going to be really interesting. We have heard Nine Inch Nails a couple of times before and reacted to them too. Let's get started. Should be really, really interesting. The Perfect Drug. Wonder what that is. The Perfect Drug should be good for you, right? It's like traditional.
It's true.
I got my head, but my head is unraveling. Can't keep control, can't keep track of where it's traveling. I got my heart, but my heart's no good. And you're the only one that's understood. I come along, but I don't know where you're taking me. I shouldn't go, but you're reaching, dragging, shaking me. Turn off the sun, pull the stars from the sky. The more I give to you, the more I die.
Oh. something unique, wasn't it?
This was.
Goa Trance and Linkin Park meets Nine Inch Nails. This was like a combination of the mechanical sound of Linkin Park, the incredible variety of music that is found in Goa Trance, and put together so beautifully by Nine Inch Nails. It was something like I've never heard before in rock music. You know, it's something refreshing, it's experimental, it's unique, and it was enjoyable, and it is the perfect drug. When you love someone so much or you care about someone so much that you consider them as your drug, is better than taking a real drug.
You know, it's kind of weird. I don't know if they meant to do it, but the song also goes in the similar fashion. It's talking about the perfect drug, and the song starts, goes to the peak, and then comes down, you know, slowly is coming down. So it's like a person when taking some kind of drug, all high and pepped up, and then slowly coming down when the energy is drained out.
Take me with you. Take me with you. What did you think about the words of this
song? The last few lines, in fact, even sounded like Kurt Cobain singing.
Yeah.
Isn't it? Take me, repeating the same lines as he does, and in the painful way, the slow manner, the way it was going. I love the middle of the song when, you know, it felt like the speaker was almost going. The speaker, what we were listening to, is almost going. That kind of effect that given. There was a lot of, you know, playing with things. I think the beginning was done on the guitar. Though it sounded like something else, but they did a lot of things on the guitar.
I like the infusion of the rave music into the traditional rave and rave music into this song. And I have a strong feeling there's a DJ in the band, or there's someone who's exposed to a lot of rave music or Goa Trance, if you know my drift.
Okay.
And definitely there, rave parties definitely have a lot of drugs going on, and what better drug to have than the one you love?
Yes, that's what it is talking about.
Your partner, your date, could be anyone, but it's a safer drug than the ones you put with a needle and a syringe into your blood.
So his drug, his perfect drug, is his partner who he loves. He really gets high on her. He wants to go wherever she takes him. Whatever she wants to do, he'll get on.
And he seems to be in a mess because he's picking up the pieces. And he wants her to be along with him on this journey of picking up the pieces. So I do not know if he's in rehab, if he's an addict already. And this is a new drug that he's exposed to, this female.
Okay.
And he wants to, you know, experiment with her too. And he's enjoying it right now. He's enjoying a high. And he feels good that this is a better high than what he got from those substances inhaled, put into the blood, or whatever.
Yeah, wow. Love the way they crafted this, the way the sound was created, all that they did. However they did, I don't know how they did it, but it was all fun. It sounded unique, it sounded new. It sounds, you know, you can remember it for a long, long, long time. Nine Inch Nails, anyway, the name itself is so intriguing. I keep saying it and then I keep fumbling, because more than two times when I say it, the third time I'm not going to get it right. Nine Inch Nails, and then it goes haywire. The perfect drug, both of the combination of the two, made a great song like this. Yeah.
Now that you talk about the title, it's very interesting. I wonder what it means. Is it really Nine Inch Nails or something else which they're talking about? So, either ways, it is a great song. It's always interesting to react to music which is, you know, out of the box, so to speak.
It's
not your conventional rock song that you're hearing, and it definitely is interesting. The last time we reacted to them too, their vocals, everything sounded different. I was wondering after the reaction, I even asked you, once the camera stopped rolling, was there something wrong with the video? We need to check before we edit and put it online. But it seemed to be the same on another couple of videos too. So I guess Nine Inch Nails, maybe we don't know them much about them.
Yeah.
So maybe they are like that all the time. And it would be a joy, and it would be really a privilege to react to a band which is so experimental, so progressive, so different. You know, mechanical. I love mechanical sounds. So when you infuse them along with trance music, Wow, I mean, this is something totally unique. Linkin Park does play around a lot with that, and you do have a couple of songs I have heard which has that experimental sounds mixed with trance, a bit of rave, you know, and there's very fine line between the two actually. And for a long time in my life, I used to DJ. So some of the times, or rather many times, I would DJ at rave parties. So I know a thing or two about this kind of music. So it was very well done. It was very well done. Experimental definitely, but well done. Because when you mix it with rock music, and with, I suppose it's classified as rock or metal. So,
yeah, I think.
So definitely it is unique to hear this. I wasn't expecting it. And it's definitely interesting. I'll listen to this a lot.
Anything unique, anything, you know, done out of the box, anything done breaking the routine or breaking anything that is stereotyped.
In a mold, yeah.
Yeah, I like that. I like that because it surprises me in different ways. Sometimes I might not like it. Sometimes it is very, very good. So this one, you know, because the vocals were of very high quality, he sang it so beautifully from the beginning to the end, and you know, it kind of, he gave it a closure to the song, singing it very beautifully, and all that done together made a lot of sense.
What do you think about this concept of a girl being a guy's perfect girl?
That's kind of common, right? Many people take their partners as the best drug or best habit or best passion, addiction, whatever you call it. It's called compassion, right?
Okay.
Yeah.
Addiction, compassion, are they the same thing? I don't know. But yeah, it's an interesting way of looking at it, and definitely it's safer.
Well, addiction, it's safer, you call it passion.
Yeah, it's safer
or
than
obsession.
Safer, in my opinion, than
any
drug that you have to put in.
That's what you're hoping in life. You're hoping in life a lot and a lot of love. And if that is there in your life, you don't really need to look out here and there and elsewhere.
Yeah, definitely. If love is in your life, you don't need to get into addictions.
Because that ruins the love.
You don't find people who are madly in love with each other being on drugs.
Yeah.
That is
for sure. They're not in love with themselves.
I have been exposed to thousands of people who have come in for counseling, and I don't think anyone who's been in love with each other is ever on an addict to anything. They usually get onto it when they break up or when they have fights or they are going through a tough phase. So that's about it, I guess, for this one. What are your final thoughts, Kirti?
If somebody is an addict, can't be in love with somebody else, I would say they can't be in love with themselves either. They can't love themselves completely. They don't even like themselves. That is the reason why they are looking for an escape, and they look into the most dangerous places and most dangerous substances, most dangerous things. So if somebody loves himself or herself equal enough to be a drug or love their partner, that is even better. You have a purpose that you're living with and living for, or whatever you call it.
One thing I must clarify, actually, I think I'm wrong about it. It's not someone that he loves.
Okay.
He is at a party or is somewhere where he's found this girl and he wants to go along with her. That's why he's saying, take me with you. They are not already in a relationship. So let's correct that. I guess we are completely wrong about them already being in love. She's someone he's probably just met. At a party, and he wants to go home with her.
I don't remember the beginning lines, so maybe.
So thanks for the request. Interesting nevertheless. I love the discussion. I hope you did too. You can check out our profile on our Patreon page and request a reaction if there are any available to us this month. Thank you.